It's Eddie Hearn, Matcher and Boxing. You are watching Sporting Icons. You don't need to be anywhere else.
Okay, so I've just watched a 7-8 minute interview conducted by former Manchester United and England right-back football player Gary Neville with the unified heavyweight champion Anthony Joshua. So thank you very much to Sonny for sending it on to me. Now, actually, before we go too much further, whenever I say Anthony Joshua unified champion, there's so many people out there confuse it with undisputed. He's not undisputed, he's unified. He's got more than one belt, okay? Now, Gary Neville, I have to give him a lot of credit because he was asking direct questions. Why are you not fighting Tyson Fury? What happened with Tyson Fury? Is there anything that you could have done to have got this fight over the line? What about the legal battle between Fury and Wilder and all that kind of stuff? So well done to Gary Neville for, well, I mean, basically he was saying it as a fan of boxing, as a fan who wanted to see Joshua Fury. So big credit to him. Now, Anthony Joshua was saying the things, of course, I've been saying for quite some time, and I'm sure other YouTubers out there as well. But of course, it's always best when it comes from the source itself with Anthony Joshua, where Anthony Joshua was saying, bullet points, of course, he was saying things along the lines of, well, we did everything that we possibly could. We showed that we wanted to fight. It was our team, as in Eddie Hearn, Matcham, 258 Management, who were actively going out there trying to get this fight done. They were the ones who went out there to get the site deal, to get the money, to get the date, get everything together. All Team Fury really contributed literally right the way up until it fell apart was heckling, moaning. This fight isn't going to happen. There's no money. You got 3 days, tick tock, tick tock. 2 days, tick tock, tick tock. 24 hours, tick tock, tick tock. That's all Tyson Fury and his camp were contributing towards it. They never went out there and actively tried to get the money. They never did anything. In fact, again, I know some people will say how Bob Arum, he would have informed Eddie Hearn that there was an arbitration going on between Fury and Wilder. And Eddie Hearn, so therefore, he knew about it. So therefore, he shouldn't have tried to get the site deal. He shouldn't have tried to do this, that, and the other. In hindsight, had Eddie Hearn not done that, what was it that the Fury fanatics would have said? Oh, well, Eddie Hearn, he don't want his cash cow getting in there with the best fighter that the boxing has ever, ever known on the planet, all that kind of stuff. You know how some of them talk. But because he did do that, people are saying, well, he shouldn't have done it. Well, were you saying that right the way through? You probably weren't. Now, I interviewed Bob Arum on two occasions, and of course I've said this multiple times now, and the videos are up here for you to go listen to for yourself, where Bob Arum said, this arbitration case, firstly, Wilder ain't got a leg to stand on, and worst case scenario is we may have to give Wilder a little bit of compensation. But no matter what the outcome of the arbitration case is, it's not going to affect the Anthony Joshua Tyson Fury fight. And he's pretty convincing about it. In fact, we was even talking about the posters. We were talking about who's going to walk to the ring first and how it's going to be billed. Is it going to be Fury versus Joshua, Joshua versus Fury, and all that kind of stuff. So he was pretty convincing. Pretty convincing. But of course, we couldn't talk about every minor detail because obviously contracts are private. It's probably the best way to put it. But even things like who was going to be showing it. Like he said to me, Sky Sports and BT Sport will collab and show it here in the UK as a joint pay-per-view. In America, it will be ESPN. In other territories around the world where DAZN is, it will be on there. So again, he was telling you that in America, it wasn't going to be on DAZN, it was going to be on ESPN. All these things were sorted out. Everything was sorted out. And again, we can go back to when Anthony Joshua, he defeated Kubrat Pulev, and this is something Anthony Joshua spoke about as well, is that after the Kubrat Pulev fight, he didn't mention the name of Tyson Fury. He said that if Tyson Fury has got the belt, then of course I want Tyson Fury. But he was saying, whoever's got the belt, I want to fight him. Again, he clarified that because there's no guarantee that Tyson Fury's got the belt. We don't know what's going on. I'm not going to give you any kind of hype or any kind of, or allow you to clout off my name by talking about you if you're not going to be 100% fighting me next. If you fight me next and you sign that contract, I'll talk about you. I'll hype you up. Tyson Fury was saying, see, Anthony Joshua, he don't want to fight me. He's a coward. He's just a big bodybuilder. He's a big stiff idiot and blah, blah, blah. See, I want to fight him. I'll tell you right now, I want to fight Anthony Joshua no matter what. He don't want to fight me. Tyson Fury was even putting out polls on Instagram saying, will Anthony Joshua duck me? He was saying no end of stuff. In fact, he even said how if he doesn't beat Anthony Joshua in the first three rounds, he's going to quit and he's still not come out for the fourth. That's how easy this fight is. It's everything that Tyson Fury was saying. The details, some of the details were put out online as well, that Fury and Joshua, it's a 50-50 split, were guaranteed a minimum $75 million each. Guaranteed. Once everything gets done, it's there. All you got to do is put your name on that contract. The fight's on. Suddenly the arbitrator rules in Deontay Wilder's favour. I mean, talk about the final hour. Was that a coincidence? Well, again, I mean, I suppose that's down to the conspiracy theorists. But ultimately, Fury could have walked away. Even John Fury, his own dad, said they could have terminated this agreement with Wilder back in December, but decided to go down the arbitration route. They could have ended it. They could have just paid Wilder the step-aside money. They could have just done that. Because the step-aside money, while it's a lot of money, is nowhere near the amount of money that he would have made for the first fight with Joshua. Bearing in mind, he's got two fights with Joshua. All these things could have happened. The WBC would not have stripped Tyson Fury because they had nothing to do with the arbitration case. So yes, for me, Tyson Fury is to blame in this one. The whole thing, even John Fury, he said this whole thing was the biggest con job in boxing. Tim Fury clearly didn't want the fight. Now, of course, John, he's not saying Tyson himself. He's talking about Bob Arum and maybe Frank Warren and a couple of others. It was all about, because they always knew he was going to be fighting Deontay Wilder. What makes it worse is that even though all the heckling and all the way through towards Anthony Joshua and his team, the fight's there, no complaints when the arbitrator ruled in Wilder's favour. No complaints. No, okay, well, what are we going to do about it? How are we going to get out of this? How much do we have to pay Wilder? Okay, well, let's explore that avenue. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Made zero effort to contribute into getting the fight on. And then finally, when it's finally in their hands to do something about it and make a contribution by pushing Wilder off to the side, they decided not to do it. But of course, you know what? There's going to be plenty of Fury fanatics now out there who will still try and give Fury a pass. Why? Because they love Tyson Fury. They don't want to see him or openly see and admit that he done wrong. His team, at a bare minimum, his team, if you don't blame him directly, his team done the dirty on us. It's one thing to do the dirty on Anthony Joshua. Okay, that's with boxing politics. But they've done it to us. They dragged us along all the way through. Of course, some people weren't convinced that the fight was going to happen. Okay, cool. You turned out to be correct. I turned out to be wrong. Why did I turn out to be wrong? Because I had Bob Arum on two occasions telling me there's nothing to worry about. The fight's going to happen. It's 100% going to happen. As long as Eddie Hearn and that can come up with the site deal and the money, this fight's going to happen. Well, Eddie Hearn did come up with a site fee. He did come up with the money. And one thing out of this, for all the people who are saying how Anthony Joshua doesn't want Tyson Fury, and not one person on the planet, not one person on the planet can say that Joshua didn't want Fury. For me, I've said it before, as I said with Deontay Wilder, that Wilder, he spoke so much about Anthony Joshua. Same with Tyson Fury, spoke so much about Anthony Joshua that when the time finally comes to back up everything that you're saying, suddenly your backside goes. Because you talk too much. Even Tyson Fury, he said that, oh well, this is just egg on Eddie Hearn's face. I mean, what kind of response is that? And then afterwards, of course, you've got this whole Tyson Fury, he's got C19 in the camp and what, yada, yada, yada. No, he didn't. No, he didn't. For me, I mean, of course, I don't know exactly what's happened. I mean, maybe he did. But I strongly believe that Tyson Fury did not have C19 and he postponed the fight because he got told to postpone the fight because the ticket sales weren't doing very well. I don't hear nothing about no 14 million ticket sales. Complete hogwash. Complete rubbish. I'm not an idiot. I can look on the line myself and I can see the amount of tickets that are still available. Well, you're telling me that the gate receipts will probably total up to about 100 million. Behave yourself. Have a word with yourself. But for me, they moved it to December. Why? Because they're still clout chasing off Anthony Joshua. They want to try and get the fight as close to Anthony Joshua as they possibly can. And of course, travel restrictions as well. The Brits can finally travel. The Brits can get the money. The Brits can pay for the tickets, the hotels and the tickets and all this kind of stuff. Now they can do it because they were struggling. Fury is a yes man. That's what he is. He's a yes man. All this talk of, ain't nobody going to tell me what to do. I fight who I want to fight, when I want to fight him. And no sanctioning body going to tell me what to do. And no contract going to tell me what to do. No promoter, no manager. Nobody going to tell me what to do. I do what I want to do. Uh-huh. Of course you did. Of course you have, Tyson. Of course you have, mate. Of course you have. Mate, you're a yes man, is what you are. If you weren't contributing to trying to screw over the boxing public and Anthony Joshua and Eddie Hearn at the same time, if you weren't part of that, well, you seem to have accepted it. Why? Because you're a company man. You're a yes man. Correct? Anyway, Anthony Joshua interview. In fact, I've spoken longer than the Anthony Joshua interview went on for. Anyway, drop your thoughts below. Click thumbs up, subscribe. Catch you on the next video.